Thank you, Jesus.
My life, like my life, my family, Reverend Cole, people that never gave up on me.
Oh, God.
People that care about me. So I am so thrilled and happy to testify to anyone to listen. What God has done for me, He can do for you. This is why I'm here.
That I have to be delivered
from, but I'm on my way. Amen. I'm on my way. It's a process. One little short story that Jesus gave me this morning on my way to pick up this predictor to come to this. He gave me the analogy of an onion. Everybody in this room can be an onion. One, because we were born, and when we were born, we stunk. Because we were born in sin. It's just the way it is. But that's why Jesus came. We have lots of layers. That means we have lots of things that need to be gotten rid of. But the good part about being that onion is that each layer gets peeled off, it can be used as seasoning to make something else taste good. Oh, so as you peel off another layer of the onion, you can put it in some soup, you can put it in your meats, you can put it in whatever you cook with to make it taste better. Our testimonies are part of those onion rings that we give to you to let you know that life tastes a lot better than what you think it does. God made the onion. He doesn't make any mistakes. I give my testimony because that's, I want you to get what I got. Delivered, blessed, set free. This is why I'm here. Amen.
I waited 56 years to speak about it, and I hadn't even spoken to my mother about it. But when I was about 6 or 7, I had one of the older guys, you know, he said he's gonna fix my bike, fix my tire on my bike so I can ride it. Told me the patches were in the basement. I went in the basement to get the patches, and he raped me. And then it was like, I wanted somebody to come stop it, and when I looked up, I seen my cousin, and I said, okay, my cousin's going to stop it, but my cousin was so scared of him, he threatened my cousin to make my cousin do it too. So he couldn't tell on him. I wouldn't tell on my cousin because I didn't want to get my cousin in trouble. I held that for 56 years. Don't do it, kids, if it ever happened to you. Do not do it. It affected me so bad to wear. When I started high school, I was scared to dress in the locker room with the dudes. I would go off to the side. I didn't want to take a shower with the guys. When we had sleepovers, they would go to sleep and find me in my pajamas. When they woke up, I had my clothes back on. I just didn't want to be myself anymore. You know, and I found out, you know, the alcohol kind of helped me not be myself, you know, take me out of myself. But then I started them drugs. And I started them drugs. It was like trying to fit in. I tried to, you know, fit in with everybody. Hanging out with them older dudes again. You know, and I knew my mom, you know, you don't need to be hanging out with them. But they kind of accepted it. But I still had that secret in the back of my mind. If I didn't do what they said, they're gonna call me a sissy or I'm this and I'm that, and I don't want nobody to know. And then the drug abuse got so bad. I was ripping off my mom. She had cancer. And I took her car and spent every dime she had. But like it says in the Bible, you reap what you sow. Guess who has cancer now? Me.
Oh, God.
But I just, one day, just couldn't do it anymore. I hit my knee and I asked God to remove the drugs and alcohol. And you know, I kind of make a little joke out of it. I said, please remove the cigarettes too, because if I got a cigarette in his hand, this one's going to get jealous. And I found a good church. And through this process, you know, people, you know, that's the only reason why I spoke the first time, because I trust my church family. But through this process, I found out something, and I heard it in a song the other day. It says, I have to quit living on how I feel
start living and his truth revealed. And that's why I'm